It's time for Turkey Pants. After overindulging, do you plan on slipping into those turkey pants, those sweatpants, next Thursday? Deanna is here. I'm going to give you some tips to keep you out of those turkey pants this Thanksgiving, although I do love getting, you know, into the turkey pants. It's like a ritual on Thanksgiving. So I said, if I could sit down with a bathrobe, I would do it, but I...
Joe, let's not do that. Let's save the family.
No. We won't. That's a visual nobody wants to see. Okay, so we're going to talk about this for next Thursday, Thanksgiving Day.
That's right.
We normally consume a lot of calories. How many would you say?
About, on average, the average person consumes about 4,500 calories on Thanksgiving, and enough, the fat equivalent to 8 greasy hamburgers.
8 greasy hamburgers.
Yeah, so there's things, little things we can do to help not have to wear sweatpants.
Well, when you say 4,500 calories, now, 2,000 calories a day is a pretty good diet, isn't that?
That's good.
That's good. So this is 2.5 times.
2.5 times, sometimes more.
Yeah.
That's the average.
For sure.
It can go higher. So there's a few little things we can do.
All right.
Sometimes people think, oh, well, I'll skip breakfast, and I won't have breakfast because we're going to have a big Thanksgiving meal. But research shows that to control your weight, to curb your appetite, that breakfast is really important. So a really good high-fiber breakfast, oatmeal, a really good cereal with some fruit is the way to go.
And we have some examples of some of high-fiber.
Yeah, high-fiber millet rice, and we've got some good oatmeal here. I just got these at Whole Foods. You know, we have Whole Foods, Jimbo's around here, a lot of options.
I always say fiber is your friend.
Fiber is your friend. The older you get, the more it becomes your friend. And the other thing we want to do is remember, a lot of times we mistake hunger for thirst. And so keep well hydrated during the day. And an easy way to tell if you're hydrated or not is, you know, really urine should be very light pale yellow. Any more than that, you're dehydrated. Smart water is a really great option. It also has electrolytes with calcium and magnesium, potassium, so that's really good.
So I should look.
You should look every time. If it's any more than light pale yellow, you need to drink more water.
Well, that's a good point. That's very good. Okay.
All right. Avoid the regular hors d'oeuvres. I mean, the regular hors d'oeuvres, the greasy ones and the you know, all the high fatty, creamy ones.
I'm not so good.
Joe's like, please don't say anymore.
No, these are the kind of hors d'oeuvres you should
have. Yes, like a fruit.
Shouldn't nibble on that. And that's the first thing you should take. That's what I try to do now. As I go, I look for the fruit and the vegetables first.
Good job.
And I walk by, if there's an hors d'oeuvre that just looks so good. Now, I have a napkin. I will take it, and I will take a nibble, and then I'll put it in the napkin. I've gotten so disciplined. I'm really good at that.
That's a very good.
I shouldn't waste food, but I save it in my pocket for the dog later.
Good job. Sorry. Good job.
Yeah, and I won't have the whole thing. So that's good.
Fruits and vegetables are always what you want to go for first.
Is there any one particular fruit or vegetable that...
No, but look at how beautiful that looks, too.
Yeah.
I mean, more color on your plate, the better. Okay, what about hydration during the day? You know, things like eggnog. I mean, eggnog has about 800 calories per serving, really fattening. When you're choosing hydration for the day, you know, light beer or wine. Wine's about 150 calories per serving, or you can get an enhanced waters like vitamin water.
Right, that's a good idea.
It's a great idea, and especially like if you're drinking and you're driving, you know, if you're driving, you know, have a drink and then mix in between water and vitamin water. It's got vitamin electrolytes in it, helps with hangovers.
And avoid those second helpings.
Avoid those second helpings. That's what we're going to get to next. I mean, what happens a lot is it's family style, and people like to load up their plate.
Right.
Well, it takes 20 minutes for the stomach to tell the brain that it's full. So are you a shoveler, Joe?
No. I've learned to set my fork down.
Set your fork down. I mean, you can even write on permanent, am I hungry? Set
the on your hand, down. Am
yeah.
I hungry?
Am
write,
I hungry?
Write it on your hand?
Write it right there on your hand and have a little battle with your hand.
And, you know, you should say it on the bottom. It says, eat the rainbow slowly. So a lot of colors.
On your plate. Eat it slowly. And one serving, like you said, last year you had one serving.
I did.
That way you can make it to the dessert table.
Dessert, you should have just a half a scoop of whatever.
Half a scoop of ice cream or a small piece of pumpkin pie.
I want to mention, before we have to run, but last time you were here, you were
5 weeks ago, I was pregnant.
Yes, and now you have a young
17-day-old boy.
Yeah, and guess what the name, the boy's name is?
We don't know yet.
TBA is what they're calling him.
TBA,
right now.
Yes. We're still trying to figure out.
I suggest
the name.
Joe.
Joe's a good name.
It's a very good
name.
It's a strong name. Thank you, Deanna, very much.
Thank you, Joe.
Right,
have a good Thanksgiving.
All right, thank you. No matter what size you wear, there are secrets to looking slimmer in your clothes. Get the skinny on looking thin when Sandy Good Living returns.